Welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Heroes Song of the Ocean Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Off screen, I ran back here, as I mentioned at the end of last video. And now we're going to the checkpoint. And then, I guess, after that, Dogarna. That's good. Borzeon Road. Could be Borza 1 Road. Alright, we're not gonna pass there. I didn't get any fights on the way back. I escaped from all battles. I got hit by like 10 different things and just escaped every time. Because some of us are about to level up, and I think you want to see that. Doggy needs healing. He'll lick himself. Ah, dressing. Lick! I just noticed those things as skulls with, like, snakes in them or something. Leeches? Hunger! Kill the leech! Charge it! Become the charge dog. We know you can be. Ugh. Nasty thing, huh? Alright, let's finish the armadillo. He's got good armor, being an armadillo. Cool. Leech is down. I was gonna do the intro after the probably next battle. Jan and Rick, level 13, McBane, 13, Una, 13. We got a leash battle S. That's why I wanted to save it, so you guys could see all the cool level ups. And what am I doing? Perfect. Hello? Oh, Bo's Earl, okay. Got stuck to the sign for a second. It's extra gummy today. Okay, nothing over here. The ape remained unaware of our existence. Not so for this one. Be a great place to put a chest. But no. I just want to make sure I don't miss anything like that, though. Nope. Alright. Oops. He bit our ankles as we went past. I'm gonna interrupt another leech. Sweet. Even more sweet. She got him in the back. The back of its skull. So I'm guessing the skull is just like its shell, and the actual leech is the snaky type thing that we see. Funny, they only pick skulls. And as they move around, it looks like the skull is eating the leech. That's sick, mister. Actually, what's sick is how little experience we got there. Oh, hey. A restore snuff, sweet. Anything else hidden around here? We continue this way, or is this a dead end? We can go that way. But I want to see what's on this screen first before we go into the next. Yeah, when the drums kick in like that, you know it's gonna be epic. Lapis lazuli. We have one already. Alright, so now we have another one. I haven't sold any yet. I'm always interested in sparkly, twinkly things. Alright, so we are going this way after all. Not interested in fighting you, though. Not with the stinky experience I've been getting. North is a whole bunch of stuff. This might be a dead end here. Ah, yes. With a chest. My favorite kind of dead ends have chests in them. Leash Battle M. Hey, you ambushed us. You were waiting around the corner to ambush us. Fine. You seek your own destruction. Who are we to deprive you of your demise? It's not worth it. Thing's dead with the next hit anyway. Alright, so maybe a tiny bit more XP. That's a strange noise. Am I headed the right? I'm not heading back, right? This is awfully. Like, almost maze like. Way about this. Okay. A noise bell. How's that? What's a noise bell? Yeah. Bell that makes noise. Monsters don't like it and encounter rate decreases. Seems like it makes sense to put on our dog, doesn't it? There you go. Noise bell. That's strange noise. So when, if we need to grind, I'll have to remember to take that off. I haven't had to grind in any of these games. You are not supposed to be doing the spawning. We came in this way, though. Didn't we? I don't know where I'm going. Have I been over here? It's all so samey looking. What did you do? Hit yourself in the head? See if there's anything down here. I don't want to fight you, but I want to see what's in here. No, okay. Little legs move so fast. Oh, come on now. Is the bell making them run away, or is it because we leveled up? Alright, please show us where to go. Checkpoint, okay. And I guess it's up here. Good. Oh, jeez. Trying to figure out if those things were floating or. Yeah, they're not floating. Okay. There's peoples up there. Hi. This is the border between Pensola and Graysol. Okay. Okay. Well, we got two shops in one. Look at that. Selling the same stuff that we've seen. Okay. No improvements, huh? Oh, wait. For Altos? He's leaving soon, though. I'm not gonna get him there. He's leaving the group soon. He's leaving when we get to the next town. I forgot what it's called. Oh, this is just like a little balcony area. Interesting. Yeah, let's stay because the dog is low on mana. Never thought I'd be saying that a dog is low on magic points. Farewell. Good luck with your travels. Why, thank you. Woo! Forte says, what's going on? You're sighing. I thought he was going, woo! Thank you for asking me. I love reading while traveling, but I got myself into trouble this time. Why? I bought too many books, and I can't pay for the accommodation here. What should I do? I don't think they accept books instead of money. Hey, I have an idea. Will you buy this Doll Knight 6 from me? Yes, I will. I finished reading it, so you can have it for a mere 30 cents. That's fine, says Forte. Forte and his friends receive a Doll Knight 6. Great. I'm reading that soon. Thanks, I owe you one. Thank you for buying the book from me. I can avoid getting arrested by the soldiers. Yeah, that's always a good thing. So if we go out here, it says, yeah, another balcony. I thought our cat fell over the edge. And if we go up here... Yeah. If they didn't have that wall there, you could go around the whole place. Okay, we got an exclamation mark. Empty rooms. We're gonna be stopped. I just want to see what she'll say. Wait a minute. You can't leave the country without following the proper procedure. I'm getting up in her personal space here. This is the embarkation counter for those departing from Graysall. Your passport, please. Forte presented the passport. Okay. Have a pleasant journey. You'll be entering Pensola. Have you finished your business in Graysall? None of your business. Oh, I don't walk there. Una says, we're finally in the Principality of Pensola. McBain says, the McBain Company's Pensola tour has now begun. I hope this trip will be as fruitful as the one we had in Graysall. Hey, Grandpa, which part of our deal with the swing gang do you find fruitful? Unexpected encounters are the true pleasures of traveling. New surprises and excitements hone the artistry of performers. Alto says, what you just said reflects the depth of your experience, Mr. McBain. I know. Altos, don't flatter him too much, says Forte. He'll get started. What are you talking about, says McBain. Una says, all right, let's calm down. We know there are resonance stones in Pensola. We should check its whereabouts. Okay, let's take a look at the map, says McBain. McBain opens the magic map. Alright, so I'm guessing there's one in Dogarna. Cave path along the way, one in Enverin. That's what the circles mean. And then there's some place called Moose here. Oh, there's Ryotam Island. I keep hearing about that one. Polka? Do they play polka music in Polka? No. There are two possible locations, says Una. Only two? Says Forte. There were five in Graysol. Two is enough, McBain says. The longer and harder the journey, the more gratification we have when we find what we want. Una says, this light is very close to where we are now. Alto says, the other one is near Enverin. Let's ask the townspeople, says McBain. Let's do that. I was about to say, where's all the townspeople? Welcome to the Principality of Pensola. A special monster alert has been issued along the road to the north. Please take extra caution. Forte says, it's unsettling to hear something like that immediately after entering the country. The Duke of Pensola, ruler of the country, is putting his heart and soul into the party on Ryotam Island. He mobilized all guardsmen, so we're short of people to guard the road. Alto says, now that you mention it, I remember seeing more soldiers guarding the area the last time I was here. It's the order of the Duke. We can't say anything against it. We must reinforce the guards quickly. Otherwise, the monsters will spread along the road, and traffic to and from Enverin will be completely severed. It's a headache. I hope Viscount Igul will talk to the Duke. Igul? One second, okay. Alright, just a window. Look at that window with the view half blocked off by this railing, I guess. Hi there, may I see your visa? McBain showed the passport. Oh, I forgot to try to walk through there to see what he would say. Hey, Altos, are you going to Enverin? Yes, I'm going to help Uncle Edgar with his store. That's so kind of you. Here, your papers are fine. Welcome to the Principality of Pensola. And, Altos? Violent monsters are popping up along the road to Enverin lately. You'd better be careful when leaving Dogarna. Only Altos gets that warning? Guess just screw everyone else, right? Oh my god. Hi, have you seen Uto? Says Rumina. Who's Uto? Says Una. Uto, don't you know him? The scared crybaby who respects the Viscount. Sorry, we probably don't know him. We're from another town. Oh, alright. Where are you? My crybaby Uto. We're gonna look around down here first and then make our way. Okay. It's an old lady. Grandma Chiana. Recently, monsters have been showing up frequently along the stretch of road to the north. It's dangerous, so be careful. Grandpa Raymond. Even though it's a monster, surely the soldiers at the checkpoint could work together to exterminate it. Yes, but don't call me Shirley. Can I pass under that? Yeah. Can I walk? I always watch for stuff like this, because sometimes you can walk around, like, you're underneath the scenery. So you guys know what I mean. Beck says, have you seen my son? His name is Uto. He is such a crybaby. Yeah, I keep hearing about him, though. I wonder where he's gone. They went to Crybaby Land to be a crybaby some more. Hold on a second. Nothing. Alright, I'm trying to scratch my foot at the same time. I was trying to figure out if that's an entrance behind that tree. Dogarna! Cave path is north 436 milos, and Enverin is north 816 milos. Good old. That building. No, we're good. Donk says, a dreadful monster showed up in the northern cave path. We can't go to Enverin now. I want to board the ship from the port of Muth and go back to Marcheros. Oh, that guy's name is Donk. Musician Tidal says, hi, fellow musicians. How's business? Are you also here to attend the audition on Ryotam Island? It's been the talk of the musician community. You'll get a lot of money if you're chosen to perform at the party on the boat. It's been the talk of the musician Ratina says, Viscount Eagle has a sad face lately. He must be concerned about the monster along the cave path. Oh, my Viscount. He looks just as good when he's worried. I wonder where he's at. There's a cave along the road to Enverin. A ferocious monster has been showing up in the cave. If you're heading north, please be careful. Yeah, heading north eventually. No one in these rooms to talk to. Oh, this is like the embassy thing. Yeah. We'll go there last then. Trying to see if there's a little path. No. I like how it says only throw them at monsters. Like, we're gonna throw them at each other. That's the one guy I talked to, right? Nothing new, yeah. I feel like we haven't upgraded our equipment for quite a while. Hold on, I keep scratching an itch on my foot. That's why I stop. Okay, have we seen everything in the town except for the embassy, I guess? What's this? Have I been in here? Yeah, looking for sun. Alright, so there's really not a whole hell of a lot in here. bigger than it looks. It's really just like spread out and stuff. Did I talk to this person? Oh, yeah, she's looking for Crybaby. What about this? Oh, that's... yeah. We've been in there. We've been in all this stuff, then. Sorry, guys. I'm just trying to be thorough here. Alright. I guess you're the Viscount. Alright, we'll talk to you. Oh, it's the butler. I'm sorry. The master is presently away. Master? Says Forte. Oh, I thought you wanted to see the Viscount. This is the house of Viscount Eagle. Oh, I'm sorry, says McBean. As you can see, we are troubadours. We're tracing the footsteps of master composer Lyon as we travel from place to place. We would like to know if you have any stories about Lyon in Dogarna. Oh, that famous composer. I hear Lyon once stayed at the Viscount's house. Is that right? Says Una. Lyon stayed in this house? Says Forte. No, not this one. The Viscount used to have a house in Enverin. McBain says, then we must see the Viscount by all means and ask about Lyon's visit. Yes, but as I said, the master is not in at the moment. Could you please come back later? I'm really sorry. It may be a while before he returns. Hey. Well. That's a fine how do you do. Nothing to be seen around here then. Cave path, I guess that's next. Whoops. I didn't mean to, I was just gonna stop just ahead. Uto says, it's a promise. Between a man and a man. Who are you talking to? Alright. Una says, he came in from the road. Forte says, that area is dangerous, with the monster and all. How can a child be walking there alone? He's got someone invisible with him. He looks strangely happy, too. Well, should we go look for him, then? Where is he? Are you the one? Get back here. Uto is humming. What's with you? Forte says. You look kind of happy. Well, do you want to know why? Yes. Okay, I'll tell you my special secret. I made a promise with the Viscount. I saw the Viscount leaving the town in armor, so I secretly followed him. Una says, the Viscount? You mean Viscount Eagle? What do you mean he left alone in armor? The Viscount was going to exterminate the monster. He said that it was his duty to protect Dogarna. He left alone without telling anyone so as not to make people worry. I told him I wanted to help, but the Viscount asked me to stay and protect Dogarna. Forte says, exterminate the monster alone? I couldn't break my promise with the Viscount. I promised to the Viscount I wouldn't tell this to people in town. Well, you just broke your promise. It was a promise between a man and a man. But you've just told us. Isn't it against your promise? Oops. Am I a liar now? Why are you hiccuping? No, you aren't, says Una. We're travelers from a different country. We don't live in this town. So, you haven't broken your promise. That's good. It was a promise between a man and a man. Yep, so we've heard. I won't tell anyone. Should we go tell the father where the kid is? I mean, the girl's running all around, but he's just sitting here. Oh. We can't tell him. Okay. He's right outside. And he's not being a crybaby. He's talking about between a promise between a man and a man. Your crybaby is right over there. Don't put on an act, Uto. A crybaby trying to look like a hero? Is it an act? Okay. I guess this conversation is over. Alright, for real this time. Leaving and heading to this cave path. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.